Every day, the Blue Waters Project at the National Center for Supercomputing Applications at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign brings previously impossible investigations and insights within the reach of researchers from across the United States and around the world.
The exciting thing about Blue Waters is it is used for the entire range of science and research. About a third of Blue Waters this year is being used for biomedical, biophysics, and molecular type research and biology research. Another part is being used for materials research, climate and weather research, and then it goes down into things like social science, demographics, economics, a whole range of things. The research breadth of Blue Waters is something that I would not have expected 3 years ago. It's expanding greatly as we have our impact of being noticed, and people are bringing to us problems that I would not have expected.
In this video, we highlight just a sampling of the more than 100 research stories from all areas of science, illustrating the breadth of Blue Waters' impact on science, education, and developing the nation's advanced digital workforce. One of this year's breakout projects is a geospatial intelligence project called Arctic DEM, led by Dr. Paul Morin, director of the Polar Geospatial Center at the University of Minnesota. Arctic DEM is a response to a request by President Obama to address the need for high-quality elevation data in remote locations.
Blue Waters is an enormous computer that allows us to process the entire Arctic in a matter of 2 years.
Paul's goal is to use satellite imaging and then create maps that are high-resolution elevation maps like you would find on contour maps of the world that are done in the past by surveying. They're using data that's coming from the National Geospatial Intelligence Agency. They're computing on that data different separate images to make stereoscopic images of this three-dimensional surface of the world.
Using any other resource, we would have to divvy this up over years and years and years. But with Blue Waters, there is enough capacity that we can feed this imagery into it 24/7 for months and months and months at a time. And the most accurate terrain of the Arctic that's ever been produced just comes out every day.
The work of Dr. Wendy Cho and her research partner, Dr. Lan Yu, is a step toward the future where high-performance computing will have an increasing influence in society and governance by applying technology to democratic ideals. Cho and Liu drew 800 million electoral maps using Blue Waters in an effort to develop a standard for nonpartisan electoral mapping. Previously, no one has drawn more than 10,000.
We created a computational tool that automates the redistricting process. It allows you to take humans out of the process, and it allows you to create maps in any way that you want to specify.
The model takes into account many social characteristics that are important to understand the implications of the redistricting activity. Can objectively determine the changes or different objective functions that people may use to determine whether one mapping is better than the other.
And when you're using a computer, you can just basically turn partisanship off and say, here are the maps, they're being drawn without partisanship. And then if you create a million of those, then you can start to understand, this is what a nonpartisan map looks like. And you can take those, say, million maps and then compare the one that the Democrats drew and say, this is what your map looks like in comparison to these other maps. You know, it's either an outlier or it's not an outlier on the partisan spectrum. And this is why you need a computer like Blue Waters to be able to extract and to analyze and to synthesize that much information for this problem.
Dr. Tiziana DiMatteo and her team have developed cosmological codes adapted to petascale supercomputers and use Blue Waters to understand how the first massive black holes in galaxies were formed, from the smallest to the rarest and most luminous. This study will provide answers to broad questions about the history and future evolution of the universe and the formation of its structure.
I run large simulations of the first galaxies and the first black holes. We run those on Blue Waters. The simulation is called Blue Tides. Having a machine like Blue Water completely opened up the study of the early universe and to, you know, simulating actually these first objects for the first time in volumes large enough that are representative of what the whole universe actually looks like.
Tiziana's work required a massive amount of memory. Blue Waters is the only machine that has that much memory that she can use to solve the problem that she was going after, which is the first billion-year evolution of the universe. What is unique about Blue Waters is it's not only a computational machine, it is a leading machine in terms of memory, in terms of I/O bandwidth. That enables a far wider range of problems that can be brought to us and done very effectively and productively.
So the Blue Water stuff was instrumental for us to be able to run basically top of the art simulations such as Blue Tides. It is when running in this very large systems at, with this kind of technology, it is fundamental to have stuff such as we have at Blue Waters that is connected to sort of to the details of how your code works, to connect it to what kind of improvements your codes need to run at this kind of scales. We were using the full Blue Water machine, so it was an extremely challenging, and having this relationship that where the experts, software, the hardware experts that are part of the staff of Blue Waters help us as scientists is how, you know, the science gets pushed forward into a totally different level. So my experience has been amazing in that front.
The future of scientific exploration and breakthroughs, like the ones presented here, require an unbreakable commitment to public outreach, education, and workforce development. Through our Dome Show documentaries, public tours, and education outreach, we are working to inspire a nation of creative problem solvers. NCSA's Blue Waters Project is developing the next generation of high-performance computing researchers and creators through fellowship and internship programs, HPC University, and workshops. By providing computational researchers with Blue Waters advanced computing and data capabilities, providing students with world-class education and workforce development opportunities, and engaging the public's curiosity of the world around us, the National Center for Supercomputing Applications at the University of Illinois and the National Science Foundation are catalyzing discoveries that will have an immense impact in a diverse range of fields, sparking new understanding of our world and opening new avenues for future research. We invite you to explore a year of wonderment, discovery, and innovation by downloading the 2016 Blue Waters Annual Report.